Good morning, and thank you for worshiping with Resurrection United Methodist Church in Hastings, Minnesota. Whether you are worshiping near or far, we're so happy you've joined us on this beautiful Sunday morning. Let's begin our time of worship with a song. Pray with me. Good and gracious God, another week is behind us. There have been many good things and maybe some challenging things too, but we know you are in the midst of all of it, Jesus. We know you are right beside us, both feeling the sorrow and rejoicing at every victory. Help us to hold on to your promises, God, and to live each day as faith-filled followers of Jesus Christ. We pray all these things in your holy name. Amen. Please join me in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
You are Glory in creation. nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus.
Well, today I'm going to be talking about peace. It's one of the things I most strive for in my own life. And now, more than ever, there are many things trying to rob us of our peace pretty much on a daily basis, whether it's watching the evening news, the stresses of homeschooling, working from home, trying to stay home. For many of us, peace may definitely be elusive or perhaps even non-existent right now. One of my most favorite authors of the New Testament, the Apostle Paul, does a remarkable job of modeling peace and contentment in his life, despite the extreme challenges he regularly faced. In the fourth chapter of Paul's letter to the Philippians, he is thanking them for their concern for him and for their gifts. He goes on to say in verses 11 through 13, "Not that I was ever in need, For I have learned now how to be content with whatever I have. I know how to live on almost nothing or with everything. I have learned the secret of living in every situation, whether it is with a full stomach or empty, with plenty or little. For I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. Sounds wonderful, doesn't it? To be content in every situation, to be in a state of perpetual peace, no matter what's going on around you. I don't know how that's working out for you and your family these days, but I know for me, during this global pandemic, there are days I definitely struggle to find that peace. I have the YouVersion Bible app on my phone. It's a great tool, by the way. I highly recommend it. Thousands of devotionals that you can read by yourself or with a friend or a group of friends. I just finished reading Get Out of Your Head and Into the Promises of God by Jenny Allen. It has proven to be a great devotional. In it, she talks about how our thoughts, fueled by our emotions, determine our actions and reactions. Allen points out that if we aren't guarding our thoughts, our imaginations, they can become weapons that undermine our faith and hope. She points to 2 Corinthians 10:5, which tells us to take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. I guess I never really thought about taking my thoughts captive, but when you think about it, it definitely makes sense. There is really no louder voice in our heads than our own. And if we aren't grounding ourselves in Scripture, spending time in prayer, reminding ourselves of God's promises and who God is, we run the risk of allowing those thoughts to undermine our faith, erode our hope, and leave us feeling anything but content and peace-filled. Paul actually offers some instruction regarding what we should be thinking about. Philippians 4, verses 8 and 9 says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you." Well, I hope you've had a chance to get out and enjoy some of this beautiful weather we've been experiencing here in Minnesota. I was sitting in my backyard this past Monday, enjoying the 70 plus degree temperatures and listening to all the birds. And even though I had literally a 3-foot pile of clothing and other things on my bed, the morning and lunch dishes still in the sink, and a message to write, I was actually able to find peace. I was intentionally being quiet, praying, and really mostly listening. It changed my whole perspective. Any agitation or worry that I had been experiencing, it was all gone. I was controlling my thoughts and intentionally focusing on the promises of God. Now, Don't get me wrong, this isn't always the case. There are plenty of times when I allow my thoughts, my circumstances to spiral out of control and really get the better of me. But if we're focusing on God with intentionality, taking the time to be quiet, to remember, reflect, and listen, the peace of God is ours. Romans 8 tells us, letting the Spirit control your mind leads to life and peace. So what are we doing these days as followers of Jesus Christ to not only experience peace, but model it for those around us? Paul said, whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice. What are people learning from us? Are we promoting peace or disrupting it? What kind of example are we setting for our children, our spouses, siblings, friends, neighbors? Are we modeling the peace of God? Maybe you're unsure how to do that. Remember, Paul didn't just magically have this knowledge his whole life. In our earlier scripture, Paul said, I have learned. And then he goes on to say, whatever you have learned or received or heard from me, put it into practice. Paul provides wonderful instruction for us regarding the peace of God. And we also learn through prayer, scripture, through worship, and meeting with other followers of Christ. All of these things allow God to reveal himself to us. One of my very favorite verses in Philippians 4 is when Paul tells us to not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, to pray with thanksgiving to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard our hearts and our minds, our thoughts, in Christ Jesus. God's peace, unsurpassed, incomparable, indescribable, is available to each one of us. We can both experience it and model it for those around us. Paul had unwavering faith in God, in God's character and God's promises. Maybe you've heard the saying, the worst thing is never the last thing. Paul considered being used by God a victory, even if it meant suffering and death. God's promises are significant, and we can hold on to that. I have a 2-year-old granddaughter. I just love to watch her play in the backyard. She doesn't have a care in the world. She's confident that her parents, her grandparents will care for her, feed and clothe her, love her unconditionally. That is the childlike faith talked about in Scripture. Are we confident that our loving God will care for us, provide for our needs? Of course, that doesn't mean nothing bad is ever going to happen, but when it does, our loving parent is right by our side, right there with us. Make no mistake, these are scary times. COVID-19 is very scary for many people. But to spend our days worrying about it, to allow it to rob us of our peace, is giving into fear rather than placing our trust in God and believing in his promises. In the 6th chapter of Matthew, part of Jesus' Sermon on the Mount, Jesus tells us not to worry. In verse 27, he asks the question, can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? Do we believe God is as big as he says he is? Do we believe he created the heavens and the earth, every living creature, every good thing? If we are called to suffer, and I believe we all are in one way or another at some point in our lives, do we believe there is a purpose behind that? God may allow certain things to transpire, but always with a promise. Don't allow your fear to bring doubt and erode your faith, taking you off the path to peace. God has made the promise that in all things, he is working for our good, for the good of those who love him. So how will you react? How are you reacting right now? Do you truly believe we serve a mighty God, sovereign, omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient, the great I am? Have you ever seen the 2005 remake of the movie War of the Worlds with Tom Cruise? At one point, Tom's character, his name is Ray, is fleeing with his young daughter, Rachel. They are under attack by aliens, and as they're leaving the house, the scene is beyond frightening, to say the least. He tells his daughter to keep her eyes on him. He says, you're going to want to look around, but don't look around. Don't look at anything else. Just keep looking at me, and everything is going to be okay. That scene makes me think of what's happening right now. God is asking us to keep our eyes on him. Stay focused on Jesus, the God of the universe, creator of the heavens and the earth, loves you more than you can fathom. God wants to give you his peace, his indescribable peace. In the Gospel of John, chapter 16, verses 32 and 33, Jesus says this, but the time is coming, indeed it's here now, when you will be scattered, each one going his own way, leaving me alone. Yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you all this so that you may have peace in me. Here on earth you will have many trials and sorrows, but take heart, because I have overcome the world.
before. Moved by the sound of his voice. Sees that I shaken and stirred. Can be calmed and broken from my regard. Through it all.
Through it all, my eyes are.
Thank you so much for worshiping with us today. To see past messages, to donate, or to get the GPS Bible study that goes with today's message, please visit our website at rezumc.org. And now, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I am praying that each one of you not only experience the indescribable peace of God, but that each one of us are a model of that peace to a hurting world. May our most gracious God bless you and keep you, in Jesus' name. Amen.